I don't know how to say, but like hard to predict. So better for the show. Mm-hmm. But as player, it was confusing, you know.
Yeah, because you can't expect the 2-0 teams, especially if they are below you, but suddenly teams have more of a chance to at least get one game off of you. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, let's take a look at what teams are bringing. I'm very curious to see. So I imagine you've been scrimming these guys a lot, both of these teams.
I never scrim Kebab.
Ah, no?
And I scrim a lot PLEB, so I kind of know what PLEB should do. Mm-hmm. And Kebab are expecting that the PLEB will not defend the A, because they don't get rotation for A, actually. They get cav and anti-cav.
Yep.
And I think PLEB normally defend A in scrim that we'd make together, so it would maybe make the game super hard for Kebab.
Yeah, I like it. I also like from seeing from PLEB, so typically we always see the shield main of Rangian plus some cav, right? And now from PLEBs we're also seeing a lot of claymores.
Yes.
That's interesting to see. And then on Kebabs it's more of the same with a lot of shield main of Rangian and of course the cav as well. No flamers and Falconetti, by the way. That is something interesting because flamers, especially on this map, have been very, very good for defense as well.
Yeah, but PLEB is kind of a team like us who really love the Coco.
Mm-hmm.
So till they got the Coco, they're fine in Exotic. Like you can see the two dual blade will get them for the wall defense. And like to defend in the tower, there is nothing better than the Coco. Because you can shoot again and again, and you do damage at the ground, so it's really, really good.
Yep, absolutely. Yeah, the Cocos are one of the best units out there, I think. They're such a fun unit to use as well.
But I think like for Kebab actually, like they know they see the rotation of PLEB with full Varanger and Claymore. Claymore are just here to buff and to give tankiness to the other units. So they know that they will full hold on A. It will be really struggling with the amount of anti-cav that they got. Huh?
Yeah, for sure. For those who don't know, could you explain why the Claymores are considered quite a good unit for the
So actually, when the Claymore get damaged, they generate a buff that give damage resistance to all the unit around. And it climbs to 30% damage reduction.
Mm-hmm.
So you give 30% like tankiness to every unit around. So actually, if you want to make an infantry push, you have to get at least one Claymore. And more you got, better it is, because it can stack. And also, you have like more at different moments. Mm-hmm. So normally, if you see a team like us, PLEB, and like all the top team all the time have Claymore in the comp because of it.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
It's just like, it just makes the Varangian better. Like, for an example, if you do a 3v3, if you take two Varangian against, like three Varangians against two Varangian, one Claymore, the one with Claymore will win, just because they got the damage resistance. So it makes the game more supportive. You have to get some unit like this in the push to just give some support.
Yeah.
So it's kind of interesting, and that's the point of this meta this season, that make the game a bit boring. It was like some of team was playing just full T5, and so you have less diversity, less last fight like with Claymore, like we got like next last season. So
yeah, exactly.
Make the game a bit less interesting to play, to be honest.
Yeah, exactly. So it's really nice to see that now with the Claymores, there's at least a little bit more variation between just Shield Mains and Ferengian, I guess. So that's already good, and then we definitely see that. Like, so you talked about about how many games go 1-1 today, especially in the Rustic, we could see that as well. Some games that were maybe expected to go 2-0 to one team actually ended up in a 1-1. So it's been an interesting day so far.
Yeah, but you know, when you are a team that is better than the other, it's like. I will take my example. I think against Pongward and even against Odin, if you compare like tonight attack against Pongward, we have like a gap in attack that they don't get. And I think we are a better team, but just on the map we are a bit attack side on this meta.
Yeah.
It's like tough to get our 2-0 because we need to be really, really better and to play perfectly. Against Pongward, we do one little mistake and we lose. So it's like, when you are a team a bit lower, it's good because it gives you a chance to do upset. And when you are the better team, it's like super tough because all the match you have to be 200% in it.
Yeah.
And that's the mistake we do against Odin also. We didn't scrim the week against Odin and we paid it with the 1-1. So.
Yeah, exactly. All right, Lulunkur on the pike this time, by the way. Actually trying to be quick on his feet, but not quick enough. Yo Flint, welcome as well. By the way, Mitch, I noticed that Kebabs are bringing two units of Banner guards here. So that's going to reset.
Yeah, but
some
I think it was basically to play around the cav.
Yeah.
But still, they have to push the wall.
Yeah, exactly.
To take
so
the infantry that they can.
Good to see they got changed out now. We'll see.
What is weird actually is the amount of pike that got kebab.
Yeah, lots of fortifier here, right?
Like not the I mean the hero. They got so many.
Oh yeah, yeah, absolutely, yeah.
So
yeah.
For them actually make a, like this is the also the problem in this meta and why Nobichis can that drop the second half of the season.
Mm-hmm.
It's like in the meta with the Vanjan and the Maiden, if you're a medium, it's impossible for you to win the fight. You get one shot too fast.
Yeah.
And so it makes you super weak in infantry trade. The only weapon with a bit of the good is like the musket, because you can steal the slow and things like this. But
yeah, so stay
you start
safe.
To
yeah.
push with that many pike. Will probably just make you lose because you will not yeah. impact the unit enough with the hero.
Yeah, it looks like Plebs doesn't want to fight with the units though, so then I guess the pikes are clearly favored. Nice exchanges here. Woo! Kick a flint taking Samurai Keg though. He'll be gone.
Actually, Kebab just want to make the ram reach.
Yeah, exactly.
That was their waiting. I think with the amount of cav that they got, they will do a bait and go with B with cav.
Yeah, they very well might. Plebs also. Oh. Still
probably the same that we do to Pongguard, that we wanna do to Pongguard.
Yeah.
That's why we got so many cav in the second rotation.
Yeah, exactly, nice pickup. Right, two dead on Plebs, so if the gate goes down quickly now, then... Ooh, Kebab's doing a B rotation though. Plebs have spotted that though.
Okay, so I think they are just faking the rotation. They will finish to destroy the gate, run to the supply, take a cav and go in the city.
Yeah. That would be nice, because then the cav wouldn't be able to... the infantry from Plebs will be able to go to the gate quick enough.
Because actually, if you look, they got two
rats.
Yeah,
running,
they are going to take the cap. Because
yeah,
actually,
them, yeah.
But the thing is, like, Plebs know that they are going to do this because with the amount of anti cap that they got three vertebrate shows, they know that they can't push like this on the wall. So it was sure that they will go to the cap.
Yeah,
it was like too easy to read for a good team.
Exactly.
So if you look, they are already set up at the gate.
Mm-hmm.
And this is terrible for Kebab, because if you do a push gate when the team are ready to hold you, it's just a disaster.
Yeah, now suddenly we are looking at 5 minutes left on the clock, so Kebabs are going to have to try and push something quickly here. They might still go for it though, I feel like.
They will have.
Yeah,
they can't
already.
Win the top push. So they have to, but it would be a disaster also, so...
Yep.
I just think Kebab, like, it's kind of already lose for Kebab actually.
Here comes the Zars, yeah, that's for the watch, you're just stopping it. Let's go.
Yeah,
they
got muskets slowing in the gate, so the cav didn't do that much.
Yep. Some of the cav is getting through, especially the pikes trying to get on the back. See if they can get flames, but here comes Zorz. That will be wiping.
Boom
in Kagan.
That's the problem. When you do a strat, but the enemy team is ready to it, they got two cav on every side to cav you after it. Like, it was already full predict by Plebs, so it's close.
Yeah, this is what some of the teams have been talking about, screaming Plebs. Sometimes it feels like they are playing 4D chess or something and you're still playing 2D. This looked like it. Now,
actually, it's quite unlucky for Kebab because I do exactly this strat Friday against Plebs in scrim. So, and I win against Plebs this, so they cannot change, you know, like work on the rotation to be ready to it.
Yeah. Interesting now though, Plebs decide they've won that fight and now they want to defend base, so... we're seeing a change here.
I don't think it's a good choice, to be honest, because they still got a full infantry for the wall and
yeah,
Kebab don't. But also, they still got the full cav rotation, so they just think that it will be safer to play at the bottom, and so they can play their cav rotation
Exactly.
Also.
Yeah, Plebs not taking any risk. I mean, they know now they're ahead, right? And with the cav gone, that means that if Kebabs want to attack that final point, they do not have the quick rotation back in with the cav, and Plebs do.
But actually, like, it's already super loose for Kebab.
Yeah.
They lose the most important rotation with the cav, who is actually leading the meta.
Yeah, exactly. So unless Plebs make a really big mistake now, and which is something that we've not seen from them. I mean, they're the most consistent team throughout the whole season.
And even more on a map like this that they play so many times.
Mm-hmm.
They know what kind of things they can do. They will hold, so Plebs basically the hold is like they hold the top of the ladder. They hold like super far on the point, so they want to block you in the choke, and they don't let you the back because they put Chev and Cav on it. So if you want rush, you get Cav by it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like super hard. I think the best way to push them, and like the way that we push them in scrim is like by the wall. You see the push that we do against Vanguard with the Namcan and the slow climb.
Mm-hmm.
It's like probably the best way to do against them, because that's the point that it's the most hard to lock for them because it's really hard to lock with the Treb and the Namcan and all the things like this.
Yeah, Exactly
So
right.
it should be the good choice for Kebab.
Yeah, we'll see.
And Kebab is swapping on full muscat actually, so they wanna poke probably, so get a top.
Yeah, they have a little Shenji out right now, even a longbow there. Yeah, now they do have the banner, but not too much cav to actually reset the charges with.
Yeah, but they have 10 muskets, so I think they want to take the top from the back.
Yeah.
And just try to poke the unit.
Yeah, Flynn, go ahead.
Yeah, can you show the number of units at sea?
Oh, yeah, sure. Here you go.
Ah, okay.
Yep. Nice. Yeah, so... Oh, yeah, nice. Yeah, right. The dual blade's doing a really good job taking out those medium armor there. That's
like
quite easy.
When you see the unit, it's close, but you have to keep in mind that Kebab lost all his cav and Pleb still have all the cav.
Mm-hmm.
And the cav actually on the ground, there is nothing to stop it.
Yeah.
So it would just make a big difference after
the
first push. Most of the Pleb player would just run to the supply, take the cav and come back on the fight.
Yep. Yeah, and Pleb is actually doing a forward defense here on the base camp. Shenji still back though. But it's only taking half of her team. The other half, in the, like you said, guarding the top spot where the muskets would be really effective. But Pleb's not giving them that room.
Actually, what Kebab is doing is super interesting. Like, they really would just you know, take the space a little bit to just give the space to the musket to send some caltrop and some bomb.
Yeah.
And they just try to kill the unit like this, but they don't want to fight, you know. If this, they stay away.
Yeah,
and Pleb can't engage with the unit count that they got. They don't get enough farm gen to go engage in a checkpoint. So they just get poked for nothing. So it's actually confusing for Plebs. They will have to go back and find.
Yeah, they're just trying to kite. And you can see in the top, Plebs used to have 1,050. Now they are below 1,000, and Kebabs haven't lost that many. So it's definitely working for Kebabs right now.
I think if they continue like this, Plebs will have to drop the front of the point and go back on the point.
Mm-hmm.
But this position, you don't really like it because then you give too much space for the enemy exotic.
Yeah.
But it's weird that. Pleb didn't play that much on the top with the top where is Bumming and Temple with some Shenji because it's like really interesting position on this map.
Yep, yeah, nice pickup there from Flynn. Once again, he's been doing it a lot. But yeah, I like what you're saying there. Like you can see, like slowly, all the muskets are just withering down on Plebs. And after a few picks that Plebs were able to get on the muskets, Kebab's playing safe now.
Like Pleb would have to do a choice if they want to engage or if they want to drop it, but if they keep like this, they would just lose some units.
Exactly.
Or even if they got some longsword, just making heal on the maiden and on the imp shield.
Yep.
Like when you get that many muskets, you will lose it.
Exactly.
You know,
and we do see Dunkel and also Wizard. Dunkel and Baltz are currently running the longsword, so they're trying to counter it a little bit there. But yeah, I mean, there's still 8 minutes, so Kebabs have around, what could we say, 4 or 5 minutes
yeah,
before
is,
they need to do
this is the point of
push.
Kurak. You never win about the time. You have the time to do so many suicides, so many pokes, so many... Like, it's really a map où you can just set up your push, and that, like, when you're at 5 minutes of the end, you do the first one, and you do the second one fast after. It's like, the time is never a pressure on this map. That's why Kebab is doing, like, full musket and taking longbow. Taking time to just set up and to poke because they know that every unit that they kill right now is unit less in the push and they will have time for it. So
yeah, and you can see they're even bringing out the village watchman just to front line, just to sit at the front, just to bait. And again, kite.
Okay, and note Pleb wanna push.
Yep.
Pleb know that the only choice for them is to push. But push in the checkpoint can be super hard.
Yeah, for the watcher brace there, we even the cap going in for Barbar. Yeah, Barbar got a killing miss as well, they're gone now though. Now, Pleb's even pushing from the front though, with Vrangian as well, Vasectomy that's pushing in.
The thing is, like, Pleb would come back with Cav now, and like, look the many the amount of Cav that come from the back.
Sakis
only
is
one
cata,
already one cata for one Chev, and like, Kebab don't have any more, and also, the fact that you have full musket for the fight, you have any unit, any hero who can dive in the back, kill the exotic unit, disturb the front lane, so you just lose on the infantry push again.
Yeah, Beku's archer is there from Moving Kagan, he's getting a meat grinder right now. And like I said, those muskets, after throwing all the bombs, just didn't have the firepower. I'm guessing Plebs waited for them to throw the bombs and then probably went in as well.
Yeah. But actually, Pleb could take quite long to take the decision, and this decision was logical.
Mm-hmm.
And you play against 10 muskets, you know that if you front engage them, the infantry push will be really easy.
Yeah, exactly. And if you now take
like
a look
this
at
the... the weakness point of the of the muskets.
And just take a look at the score right now. By the way, base pretty undefended, so if Kebab's rush, maybe they could get a position, but even then they should be losing the fight. But Kebabs just lost around 400 units and Plebs only lost 50, so that's a huge gap right now. Kebabs trying to make the most out of it. They need to be quick on this attack. I feel like Armiger is going to the point, but that's getting wiped by Hussars once again. Sekis, oh my goodness.
Yeah, it's weird what he's doing, Kebab. Yep. Half of the team is not pushing, other half is pushing.
Yep.
I think he's like, they know that it's GG actually.
This looks like a GG here.
Pleb do it perfectly. I think they still take a risk to go back on final, but but yeah, it was like after the first push, we know that it was already win.
Yeah,
actually,
yeah.
In the meta that we play, if you win the first push and you still have this unit for the rest, you know that you win.
Yeah,
it's like the same in CBL. The first when you are in two rotation of T5, if you still have half of a rotation, it's not like you when you get half of a T4, you know that you are going to win the last trade with it. So.
Yeah, exactly right. Yeah, so very strong defense here from Plebs, and considering that right now we believe this map is attack favorite, we'll have to wait and find out how the defense goes from Kebabs in our next game. Still 4 minutes on the clock though, so this is going to be a rough one for Kebabs. Amiya and Sekis will probably be looking to get some more hero kills here. If he can get him down though. Yep, but that's it. What would you have done differently if you even wanted to try and beat this, what Plebs did?
Actually, it was pretty loose at the draw.
Yeah,
like, when you know that you can't win the top, and that's why they got so many cards and they want to do the B-rush. Because if you do the... Like, I prepare the same for Penguin, so I can tell you. Like, actually, if you prepare a full rotation of cards for B, you don't have to gamble a rotation for the wall without anti-cav, so that means that if the guys didn't defend the wall, you still have a good comp.
Mm-hmm.
But at this point, if you play against a team that pre-shot that you are going to do this and are set up at the gate, this strat is like a bit cheesy, you know? And so the problem of the bait is what, like, they bait that they will wall push with like 6 Brasio, and Pleb is not stupid. Or like, they know that it's like, they will never push like this because it's a winnable trade, so... It was too easy to read the thing.
Yep.
They should do a better rotation to bait more.
Yeah, probably should. You know, Barbar just dancing here. They know there's nothing left to do. Yeah, interesting to see such a convincing game again from Plebs. Kebabs, of course, wanting to like, contest them. Is there a unit that, like for example, the Flamers and the Fognetti were banned? Would those units make a difference with the strategy that Plebs did? That
actually, really not. Falconetti can make some difference, but on the club of the strata club, it's kinda the same as us. No way, you don't give the space to the Falco in the tower. That's the mistake that we do in our match. But and so that's they do the same defense as us club. So even if you're Falco or Flame, you can't really burn on A. And on final, it's not about this. It's like, anyway, with the difference that you make on A, it was already done. I just think like Kebab don't want to prepare an A push. And it was kinda loose at the point of play, but prepare just a defense or A, so... That's kinda the problem of the meta that we point with Amiya last time. It was like, this meta is a bit about conflip. You have to conflip if they will defend wall.
Mm-hmm.
If they don't defend wall, that you have to get a lot of anti-cav and cav, because the cav is so strong, so you have to be really... like big draft for it.
Mm-hmm.
Before, the cav wasn't that strong, so you didn't need a big draft for bottom, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
No, if you want to play a team fight bottom, you need a mount of Modo and cav. Mm-hmm. That is crazy. And so that makes the wall defense strong, because you can just bait that you will be at the bottom and get full Varangian on the wall. Mm-hmm. And it's the same than the cav. If you want to beat Varangian, you have to get a lot of Varangian and Claymore.
Mm-hmm.
So this meta is super conflict. And that's why we don't like it most of the player and the team.
Yeah, it's pretty rough. I mean, the meta at the start of the season looked to be quite good actually. The first 3 or 4 rounds, I think. It was felt a bit better.
Yeah, it shifted for the fourth round.
Yeah, absolutely did.
That when the maiden gets up and gets really meta,
mm-hmm.
and everyone starts to play it.
Yeah, exactly. And then also the Varangian when that was noticed as well. Yeah.
Yeah, that's. That's sad for the game, because I think the meta of the last season was super interesting.
Yeah.
With the amount of T4, because like it's more interesting to see a game with T4 with a lot of fight,
mm-hmm.
a lot of different type of units, than just big block of Maiden and Varangian capping everything.
Yeah, Yeah, exactly. And
or just double cav.
Exactly. Like, it almost makes you wonder, like, we've seen some tournaments in the past, like our tournament, which was just T4.
Yeah, I missed this. With the stalwart meta, it was crazy.
Yeah, that was really
so
good,
skilled.
Right? Yeah.
But actually, really when good. You see how Seth come back and die in the tournaments, they just, like, abuse of the double cav meta. They play double cav on close to every map. And sometimes they bait with double infantry and they just like play on this because there is no counter to the double cav. It's impossible to play against it.
Mm-hmm.
So it kinda like it just destroy a bit the fact that the tournament the best team win all the time because you can win just with the draft and with the unit that you choose to and the way that you choose to play the map.
Yeah, and of course that's also part of the game, right? Getting a good draft, getting the right like choice, but it is a bit sad if you win because you outthink the opponent before the game, of course. So. Alright, Plebs leading the game now, 1-0, winning the defense. Let's quickly go over the heroes and then we'll get ready for the next one.
Does it get 11 medium in this match?
Yeah, that's an absolutely insane amount of medium. I think it may have been the most out of any game. Wing Pro Kagan picking up
the
MVP here. Yeah, 119 unit kills. Most unit kills were from Boom and Kagan. He got a huge Huzar charge at the gate. That was nuts. And I think he did it later on the supply as well. So, really good job. Sexy Bob, by the way, getting the MVP matters because the MVP award, he was tying it for the first place with three other guys, and now he will probably be in the lead. So, that's going to be interesting. And Barbar getting 46 unit kills. He needs a lot more if he wants to maintain his first place for most unit kills. So
I think for the first kill fight, Amya already, I guess, so get a so big lead.
Yeah, yeah. Only Sekis can actually catch up to him.
Yeah, but he will not.
So yeah, exactly. They already agreed that Amya should be taking it. So we know what's going to happen there. We should know it. Yeah. Alright, time to set up the next lobby. Plebs will be attacking. It will be interesting to see if Kebabs can do something similar or different. We'll see. Alright.
But actually, it's good also to point that Plebs like keeps screaming and Pongward Kebab is not really screaming this tournament.
Mm-hmm.
You see, like he's focusing on purple. So you feel that feel also that they have less preparation that Pleb, you know, on the match overall. Because the final attack was, the Kenda don't know what they do. They try to play full musket to bomb, but there was no, you know, pressure point on every side. It was not like work like a team who is ready, you know.
Yep. Yeah, absolutely. And I feel like this has been true for Kebabs more often, to be honest. There's been a few games where they just didn't seem totally focused or ready.
Yeah.
So.
And even the main 15 actually on the pitch is not the best one. Probably five players who are not in the main 15 normally.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
So yeah, I think they just like, to be honest, lot of team, and it's not about like the tournament or anything. It's like lot of team drop the motivation for the game, because of the meta basically.
Yeah, I mean that's true. You can see it in TW as well, right? And it's just, I mean even for myself, it's true. Like this current meta, these past few weeks, I think I've been playing less than I've ever played this. This meta right now.
It's the same for me. Like all the team that we try to scream, most of the time cancel because they don't get enough player who want to play the game anymore. So, kinda sad for the game.
Yeah, it is. I mean, it can be such a great game, but the meta shifts are sometimes just too much.
And that's why we get so many fights with Temple in the Captain General to ban the Liao because we were like, okay, the game is already not fun to play in Siege and in Ranked and in TW. Let the tournament be at least the proper place, because even if it's not the best meta of the Maiden and the Dungeon, it's still more fun to play than 15 years. So yeah, you make the good choice about it. A lot of people cry, but...
Yeah, apparently. Yeah, of course. I mean, this is something that you don't know at the start, right? So at the start of the season, I made the decision to play almost each map twice. Because for two main reasons. First is that teams have less maps to prepare because the burnout was real, right? 7 maps in one season is a lot of maps. Some of the maps, of course, you've already played before, but it's a lot to prep so many maps again and again. And then the other reason was that it would be very interesting to see, I think, how throughout the season the meta changes, and then a map could suddenly be very different. And I think this has been true for most maps. We've seen different games despite playing on the same map twice.
Yeah, and then as captain, you like it's impossible to just go in the match and play the same strat, because you know that the enemy team will be ready to do strat you make.
Exactly, you need to make some adaptations. Also assuming what the opponent has done and what you have done. So it it creates more of a storyline as well for casters and streamers and people who are watching to go back to a map and say, oh wow, these teams have played each other in that map. Or like you, for example, against Surfslayer, right? Playing on Hidden City last season was a great match, and then this season you're coming back to that same map again, play against Surfslayer. Like, those kind of stories are really cool to talk about.
Yeah, yeah, of course. But actually, the regret for me is this map became kinda like Elk is kinda unbalanced in terms of side. Kurak also, so play two times map where unbalance is not the best.
Mm-hmm.
So may I think next time, next season, if you can find some map who maybe have, like Kurak is map too much work, like many teams know to play it. I think a map like the Great Glory and like this are maybe more interesting. Also original, because there is many points, so many way to defend. Kurak is like 2 points, okay, 3 points with B. One enter, least, you know, not many way to do. So I don't know.
No.
I don't really. I like the fact that you want to put less map for us, the captain. So it was less tough than last season,
mm-hmm.
to be honest. But I didn't like the map that we played twice.
Yeah, I get it. I mean, it, and that's always right. I mean, different teams and different players like different maps. So that will always be true, right? There's no way to please everybody. So in the end, someone has to make choices between, okay, what maps are we going to play, and even then, like, the maps change also throughout the season. Even this season, some of the maps have been changed, right? Like, what was it, Riverlands Castle, I think, the map which was like unattackable because of the sea point. They now added that approach on the left. Do you know what I mean? What map was that?
Oh yeah. Valley Fortress?
Yeah, Valley Fortress, yeah, exactly. Valley Fortress, yeah. That map was like unattackable, and now we don't. I'm kind of curious, I don't know if anyone's played it on like a
sprint. There's many ways to defend this map, which is probably one of the most interesting that you can put.
Exactly.
Also, Lenberg was a good one when you put it.
Mm-hmm.
So. But, I don't know. I feel like, and this is why we were talking with Arcanob before in the French cast. It's like, depend of the showdowns and which map to play which team, like your tournament is so tough. For an example, Pleb, the worst map of Pleb is probably the Fjord, and they was lucky to fight against Odin on it, and not against one of the top
top four.
Us, we fight Odin and Pongward were the team just below the top on map were attack side, so on Elk and Kurak, so we drop game against them. We drop the two defense against them. And like, it's like, you know, I feel like if I play the team on another map and
play the team on another map,
exactly. Result can change. And so there is also a part of the RNG.
Yep. All right. Here we go. Yeah. I mean, that's something else that's interesting to talk about. Like what, depending on you may favor some maps and stuff like this. And of course, at the start of the season, you never know what map will be favorable to you. Like some teams don't like a map and suddenly they play really good on it, stuff like this. But all right, before we have more of this discussion, let's head into our match. It's the final game and match of the Feudal division. KEBABS this time in the defense, PLEBs on the attack. Currently PLEBs leading 1-0 because they won the defense in quite a convincing way. So we're gonna find out how they do on the attack this time. What are we seeing for the units? And what do you expect?
I'm surprised to don't see a double cav.
Yeah.
On the kebab side.
Yeah, kind of like what Surfslayer did earlier today.
Even worse, because the USA are up, so they can just and the Kataf, so they can just play Kataf and USA. But actually, okay, they start to get a lot of cav.
maybe switching around a little bit. A lot of of course, Sekis and Amiya are setting on the double cav. That's always the same story. Especially whenever it's possible, but a lot of heavy infantry, double purple I'm surprised.
Okay,
to see
they
that
will
many.
Not. They will not defend the wall for sure.
No.
Kebab. They will go instantly for the final. Maybe try to take a trade on B with the cav.
Yeah.
And for pleb.
Yeah, I feel like plebs are just anticipating a lot of cav with all the modal for the Brock show that they're bringing.
Okay, I think pleb is a bit lucky because they get a. They don't really get a big wall rotation. They got full bottom rotation and kebab don't defend the A, so pleb already kinda win the coin flip for the draft.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's find out how it goes. So pleb draft favors according to Machine. We'll see if your galaxy brain holds true in this game as well. Oh, did you find a name for the defense?
Yeah, we want to call it nobles.
Nobles.
No walls.
No walls. I like it. All right, no walls. There you go. Where you got a name for the strategy? We'll use it in the future seasons for sure. All right. Oh, Leoncourt taking the first shot at Temple Shield though. I like it. Shots fired there. No temple. That's maxi. All right. So not fooling around. I'm just trying to get up on the wall. He won't be able to, as long as they keep kicking those ladders though. Yeah, the battering ram, that's something else that we've discovered this season, right? All teams always trying to stop the battering ram, making sure it doesn't reach the gate.
There is a recent bug on battering ram.
Yeah.
I think
it just stops whenever
patch.
A unit gets hit, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
And it makes horrible
yep.
the fact that you push the ram. Because actually, it's easy to make the ram never reach. Because even if you try to put an arrow on this, it's really easy to cancel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, exactly.
So,
it's really
no, we destroy the gate with the treb and the hero most of the time.
Yep, exactly. Alright, looks like. Okay, Amya's going down. I'm guessing it's Amya. Yep, alright, Amya almost was up on the wall, but then he had to jump down. Yeah, so at least you can steal the shorty gate, right? By just hitting it with your heroes or using artillery or using a trebuchet even. So,
yeah.
It's not like it's an unbroken, like totally broken thing, but it's really annoying. Fact that you can't really get into the gate that easy.
To be honest, I didn't expect Kebab to defend with this
yeah.
comp, like the A, because they got two chev at the bottom, they got one model, one brassio, so that's already four units mm-hmm. who are bad on the wall, who can be on the wall.
Yeah, I feel like they may be just using the chevaliers in case plebs do push into the city, and then they might switch to another unit whenever they do go on the A point.
Like the problem is like when you got Chev here, that means it's impossible for you to retreat.
Mm-hmm.
Pleb will destroy the gate with zero. So like if they want to retreat, they have to retreat now or they get fucked.
No.
Okay, Kebab will open the gate, I think. And try look the gate. They will open the gate and try to kill the hero with the Chev.
Yeah,
yep, it's open, there we go. And now they're shooting.
Okay, they didn't have one. But they dropped the top for free actually. There's
no one.
No one for the left tower. If they wanna go.
1v1 here on the left though between the dual blades. That's going to be interesting. Oh, Razin getting help. Yeah, so interesting rotation there again. Better than getting delayed, and especially on this map, I feel like it's so important to at least have the option open, right, to go to that B point, not only to have to fight for the A point.
And meanwhile,
look what Amya is doing on the.
Yeah, nice pickup there though. Did you notice Atelier's getting killed by Sakis? Yeah.
And yeah, if you look on the right wall,
yeah,
Amya
yeah.
is like sliding on the wall so he can come back every time he wants, so he's like forced to stay next to him.
Yeah, he just continues to be a nuisance. Yo Flint, welcome back.
yeah.
Welcome. Okay, Kebab will full force through the middle tower. This is probably the worst tower to push, because you got a group on the boss side. So you will get clapped from two sides, you don't want it.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm kinda confused if Pleb wanna go straight by this way, to be honest.
Yeah, they do of course have the opportunity to use traps here. So that's always one thing, but traps not extremely effective, I feel like.
Okay, they rotate for B, they will trap the rotation.
Yeah.
And they will full rotate for B. Try to put some slow off musket maybe.
Yeah, exactly.
And actually, okay, Kebab is already like so late.
Yeah.
Most of the Kebab people are already already not moving on the point.
Nothing really hit on the trap though, so that's something good, but I do wonder, like, Amya still here being a nuisance, slowing them down even further. He needs to go down
now,
but
the
Plebs will be able to get
the space,
yeah.
The treb. Then we get the space to play the exotic.
Exactly. And another
Kebab have still five people on the ground with the Chev and the Modo.
Yeah.
So it would be a fight supra like
yeah.
It would be unfair in terms of number and in terms of units, so
yeah.
I think PLEB would just like destroy them.
Kebabs were lucky with the trap though, it didn't really hit. Anya still on the back, by the way. A is being captured meanwhile, so regardless of whatever happens.
Triple Varangian on A. Winning the main, they are winning the main push also. Because they got more exotic on it.
Yeah, frontline still holding strong though for Kebabs, to be honest. But still, Kebabs starting to slowly lose ground and starting to lose the fight. I'm still sitting in the back chilling. Here comes another charge in. Still Palace Guard in play, but those are getting all wiped out.
Yeah.
And clean wipe here from PLEBs, only losing 3 heroes, 8 heroes down from Kebabs. Kebabs need to forward
exactly
read down to the base.
And the Chev at the gate also, they lose the supply already.
Yeah.
Already, it's like the situation was super bad for Kebabs.
Exactly.
The rotation that they got was not good to play the wall, they didn't play the best position, they were slow on the rotation. There was too many things who make them lose on this.
Yeah, exactly. It probably would have been better to abandon that rotation after being slow, like you said. Maybe just not fight, save the units, try to go inside the city, kill that small group that's on A, and then go back to the base. But
okay, they got push, they got a lot of Chev. I don't know, look like they want to sit up on B. They are going out, and we know that they get a lot of cav, so
exactly.
There is a possibility that they try to defend B with.
Yeah. And I mean, they do kind of need to make something happen here, right? Because they are now down a lot of units. If you look at the top, only 760 and 1,000 for Kebabs. So Kebabs or for PLEBs. So PLEBs almost haven't lost any real units. Couple of frontline units, but other than that, almost everything is still there.
I'm expecting, a big cheese from Kebab, because actually when you are behind, and even when you commit less than another team on tournament, you have to do something different.
Mm-hmm.
And actually the defense on the wall wasn't, I don't know, don't feel like they try to make a big difference on it. But like, no, they got full cav on B, maybe they will try to get something like this, but when you see the amount of pack that got pleb, the amount of modo of Brasio and all these things, it would be really tough.
Yeah, exactly. Nice trap dodge. And yeah, here comes the cap. So this is what we've seen 3 weeks ago. The cap defense. PLEBs have been very vocal about that. They know a way to counter this cap though. Ooh, first cap QR is wasted there. Dodge by the
right just, just shave, it's just shave.
Yeah.
To make sure the retinues. The main part of the cav would be the one coming from the bat, the back, because the front is just to bait a bit.
Yeah.
Normally in this meta the cav all the time.
Here it goes. PLEBs have a nice spread though. They're coming in from the gate now as well with the Uzars. Kebabs getting in some nice kills though.
There's still a full modo in the middle of the PLEB, but they get wiped on Nero just because of the cav.
Yep.
But this trade is not good for Kebab, because they will lose all the cav on this. And PLEB just lose some anti-cav for it, so.
Yeah, and some specialists of course, but yep, that's it.
When you zoom on the fight and look the amount of cav that is still alive is maybe like 2 cut off, but nothing more.
Yeah, everything is like half health right now, so one cataphract there, half of the chevaliers, some chevaliers full health, but not too many, yeah. Kebabs did manage to close a little bit of the gap though, so, but like you said, PLEBs do still have the double rotation, so they can still go infantry and then go to cav. And Kebabs only have one rotation left basically, and then they are left with blue or gray units. And also notice that the Kebabs or PLEBs brought a lot of triple units, right? Where Kebabs brought a lot of double gold.
Yeah. And this is like the point of when we ban Liao and not Yusar and Kataf. The difference is like Liao, you don't have CD, and like when we play a good mount of Liao, you one shot the unit so fast that you don't lose HP, so you can trade your cav without losing them.
Mm-hmm.
When you play around the Kataf and the Yusar, you know that you are going to lose them because after the charge, the Yusar, for example, they have nothing to do during 60 seconds, so it's free to kill.
Yeah.
So at the end of the fight, you lose most of the Yusar all the time. And it's kind of the same for the Kataf. So when you do a comp like this, you know that you are just going to trade 1-1 with your cav. So you have to be sure that you win the first fight to do it. And actually, they lose the first fight. So they know that if you watch the rotation, they got some Dimakateri, they got some blue rotation, they got some Tercios. So they are pretty bad rotation compared to PLEB.
Mm-hmm.
So it can die already, like You can think there is a chance, but it's already lose just because of the comp that they got actually.
Yeah, exactly. If PLEBs actually execute right, and if KEBABS execute the same, but then in the end PLEBs should be able to come out on top. We'll see what happens though. KEBABS doing slightly different stuff here. They're trying to flank in the back, yeah.
They drop the back, so that means that KEBABS will not get any more units. It's impossible for them to play any units, so that means that they have to die if they want to come back, and they already have two deaths or one death on most of the people, mm-hmm.
Yeah, KEBABS trying to get back the other supplies so that at least they've got something. They're also going for the Hussars there.
But
from
the position that, like KEBABS, if you give the back, you give the back supply, you give the top of the enemy. So here you can see Coco and Shenji are going for the top. That means that they will get exotic at the top, they got supply against you. You give too many things to the enemy. On this map, on Kurak, if you don't defend the back, you lose the final all the time. It's all the time the same process. They will take solid the top, they will bomb you, and after they will push you, they will keep the supply anti-cap, so it's impossible for you to come back.
Yeah.
And us, like, and the attacker can just like come back on the point with from the outside. So.
Yeah, right now KEBABS just lost all control of this map. We still even saw Leon and Kur losing against Amya on the 1v1 on the flank there. So this means that Amya is still inside the city with his Kef ready to get in from the back. KEBABS,
I'm surprised that they totally dropped the supply position and they don't defend it or just anti-cap it. They are pretty confident that they can just one-tap the push with the exotic that they got.
They're probably just confident in their 15v15 right now, which makes sense there. Both of the dual blades also inside the city, right, with the Kef. So, and then most of them also can still switch to the Kef. They have control of their own supply still, so...
And with the unit meta actually, the fact that Pleb got 4 Vengeance, it makes the fight impossible to lose. Because it's not, you know, before the push, if you were sniping the exotic more faster and things like this, you have a chance to upset a match, like a fight with a lower unit. In this meta, with the Vengeance, it's impossible that you upset if they got more than you.
Mm-hmm.
So if you see, like, just watch the 4 Vengeance of Pleb, they will go to the front and they will destroy it alone. On the left, they start to go.
Yep, there they go. So, a lot of Shenji and Sicalian on top of the wall. The high ground is definitely there for Plebs. They're also already blocking the entrance from the resupply. And for the Roger raised on the point, so nothing to get in there. The front line from KEBABS is definitely quickly losing as there comes the Hussars from Amya. Well, or Cataphrax, my bad.
Cut from the back.
And that's the wipe.
The exotic free DPS, there is everything.
Yeah.
The setup was perfect, they give all the space.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, perfectly executed here by PLEBs. You can see it, only 5 left alive for KEBABS, but they're nowhere to be found around the cap point. So these capture points will be coming in quickly. PLEBs still got all of their units and heroes left from that push. We can see KEBABS starting to lose the battle and also starting to leave the fight. This is in favor of PLEBs, so they win out strong. Only dropping one game to you, Matt, this season.
Yes! I'm the only one to beat PLEBs this season.
Exactly.
That's good.
Right.
I'm happy of you. I will keep this.
Alright, that was a great match. Let's see. PLEBs showing why they are the back-to-back-to-back champions here. MX New actually picking up a lot of unit kills. That's going to be good for his...
And you? You know when I say that when you take a fight with Cav, it's 15-15. If you look the second fight, they lose exactly the same amount of units. Just cause like, it's the way that you play the Cav, you lose your Cav after the trade.
Yeah.
So even if you, like, you win the fight cause you kill more hero, cause the Cav is like more impacted than infantry on hero, at the end you lose the trade, like, you just do 1-1 on the trade, so it didn't make the game easier for you.
Yeah.
That's why most of the team don't wanna play double Cav in defense, cause it's still conflict.
Yeah, you just need to win really hard then, instead of getting 1-1. Alright, just taking a look at the stats here. Good stats all around. You can see that second fight was really close, or was actually in favor of KEBABS, right? But like you said, they had to trade all of their best units, basically, just to gain that small advantage. And then that wasn't enough to come over that big loss at the start of the game. You can see the final fight was just as big as a gap there.